This video is for anyone who's on Facebook, Twitter or Instagram. Basically, you're being mind controlled by a company in Manchester. Don't believe me? Just watch this report. You might want to shield your eyes if you're averse to smug cunts. Sorry for the language, but these are the most vile bastards I've seen on TV in a while.
As big brands look for new ways to engage with millennials, there's been a massive shift in their advertising strategy towards social media. But the people who best understand how to gain traction on social networks are millennials themselves. So brands are paying very young people shocking amounts of money to market to their peers. And it's working.
So this new role here, what is the answer to the question, what would the last supper look like if it happened today?
Social Chain is the creation of Steve Bartlett, a 24-year-old university dropout.
24-year-old smug cunt. He is fucking loaded now because of what he's doing to you. Not me, because I'm not on any of these piece of shit social media experiments. But him and his little cohorts are creating what you read as news and as things, as items for sale and everything. And they're very smug about it. They're very happy about it. They see themselves as the Illuminati of social media. They've got 400 accounts and they flood Instagram, Twitter and Facebook and fill your little minds with their shit that they create off their cuff. It's not even the truth. They're so happy that they're just peddling shit that brings money into them. I mean, look at this twat. Oh, you piece of shit. I tell you, if anyone's thinking of terrorist activities, take it out on these fucks. Because I'd laugh my head off. Not that I advocate violence, let's get that straight.
In 2014, Steve started hiring the authors of popular social media channels, often teenagers living at home, and brought them into one company. They own more than 400 popular accounts across a number of social media platforms and use them to influence what young people talk about online. So you're not representing digital influencers. What you do is you find the digital influencers and you bring them in.
We are the digital influencers.
We are the digital influencers.
They're creating content for their Love Food channel on Instagram, which has almost 7 million followers.
I mean, did you see how smug that fucker was? We are the digital influencers. You piece of shit.
So you've just posted a picture, yeah. And that's your notification. Revenue grew by nearly 600% last year to almost $7 million, and it's projected to double in 2017.
I've increased that.
The creative team gave us a demo of how they can set the conversation.
So today we're just trying to think of something that we could hit the trending topics on Twitter. There's so much conversation on Twitter right now. It's all Brexit and Trump.
Are you going to think of a hashtag now? What is it that you're thinking of?
Yeah, I think if we went with hashtag American versus British.
So, Brexit and Trump, the whole conversation among young people is being controlled by these fuckers in a room in Manchester. You think you're on social media, putting your own view across. It's being controlled by these fuckers.
Hashtag is going to be American versus British.
Yeah, game on.
And you got half an hour. Okay.
Let's do it.
You have a lot of young people working for you, but you also work with a lot of companies run by older people.
Mm-hmm.
Are you just blagging it? Are you just a bunch of kids who've got together who are convincing old people that this is how you do things?
My honest response to that is I don't think you can get this far by blagging it.
While we're talking to Steve, word comes from the creative team that their hashtag has already gained traction.
She's celebrating because it's trending.
They started trying to make this trend at 4 o'clock and 11 minutes later, number 6 in the United Kingdom, trending topic, American versus British. I think we easily win this by not having Trump, who wants to eat a stupid cookie when you can have a glorious biscuit. That's impressive, but are you transparent? Because when I log into Twitter and I see American versus British in my head, it was somebody who sat around, came up with something, and then that caused a trend. Do people know that you're behind
it? That's exactly what you just described there. So you said there's a group of people that sit around, they come up with something, they put... That's exactly what you just seen here. These are the people that before this was a weekend together, were sat in their bedrooms, influencing all those trends. The only thing is now they do it here.
So you're a group of influential individuals who've realised that collectively you are an Illuminati.
You say. Okay, they're not our words.